Yes. So this is my 25th video on complex analysis in the playlist of UPSC Maths Optional. So in this video, what you're going to do is you're going to see Laurent theorem, right? So Laurent series, it's a very important problem topic in UPSC point of view. You will have almost 60% of problem each year, right? So what this says is that let C1 and C2 denote respectively the concentric circle C1 and C2. So C1 is one concentric circle. Concentric circle means you know, right? So C1 and C2 are concentric circles. With C1 is the big circle is C1, right? So center is Z0 and radius is R1, and the C2 is a smaller circle inside C1 and the radius is R2. Let f of z be analytic in a region. So you can see the function is not analytic in this region, but it is analytic in this region, right? It is analytic in this region. So our f of z is analytic in a region mod z minus z0 in between R1 and R2. Then if you take any point z in this region, then it can be represented as a power series of positive or negative powers of z minus z0 given by f of z is equal to summation bn by z minus z0 whole power n plus an z minus z0 whole power n, right? Yeah. So don't worry about the statement of the theorem. So let me get to the problem, then it will be very useful for you, right? So I'm going to solve only 5 problems on Laurent series. If you understand that 5 problem, you can solve any problem in your own, right? These 5 problems are very important, right? Yeah. So if they ask new question also, the number will be different, that's it, right? So expand minus 1 by z minus 1 z minus 2 as a power series in the region. So there are 2-3 problems here. First we need to expand in this region, and then we need to expand in this region, and then we need to expand in this region, right? So before getting into the, whenever if you have a problem for Laurent series, you will always have a singularities, right? You can see here, 1 is singularity, 2 is singularity, right? So we can expand in between 1, if we cannot expand this in real series expansion at 1 and 2, but we can expand less than 1, greater than 2, and in between 1 and 2, right? Yeah. So before getting into the problem, whenever if you have a problem for Laurent series, you just have to make a partial fraction, because you will always have this sort of denominator. Either you will have a quadratic equation, you have to factorize, or you have the factorization itself, right? So first we need to resolve this into a partial fraction. So you know how to make do the partial fraction, right? This will be a by z minus 1 plus b by z minus 2. So I need to multiply by z minus 1 z minus 2 to all the terms. We multiply, we will have a into z minus 2 plus b into z minus 1, right? What I'm doing is I'm multiply by z minus 1 z minus 2 in numerator to all the terms, right? So if I multiply into z minus 1 z minus 2, this two term will get cancelled. If I multiply z minus 1 z minus 2, this two term will get cancelled, and if I multiply here z minus 1 z minus 2, these two terms will get cancelled, so we have these terms, right? So whatever you have denominator, you have to multiply this by entire numerator. Now we need to find the value of a and b. So put, these are very elementary, right? Put z is equal to 2. So if you do that, we will have a will get vanished and b will be 2 minus 1. So that means our minus 1 is equal to b. Now we have to find a, put z is equal to 1, right? So if z is equal to 1, and this will be minus 1 is equal to a into 1 minus 2 plus b into 0. So this means our a is equal to 1, right? This means a is equal to 1. Because this term gets vanished, we have minus a is equal to minus 1, so a is equal to 1. So we can write minus 1 by z minus 1 z minus 2 as a by z minus 1 plus b by z minus 2. So therefore our value of a is 1 by z minus 1 minus 1 by z minus 2. So first step, whatever you have, is you have to make a partial fraction in Laurent series, right? So therefore our f of z is now changed to 1 by z minus 1 minus 1 by z minus 2, right? Now we'll come back to the problem. So first division is, we need to expand this in mod z is less than 1, right? Mod z is less than 1. Now, mod z is less than 1. Yeah. So you need to make, you need to have this series 1 plus x the whole power minus 1 is equal to 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on. And 1 minus x whole power minus 1 will be 1 plus x square plus x cube and so on. And both are valid only if mod x is less than, strictly less than 1, right? Yeah. Now, what you have to do is, we need to expand this in mod z is less than 1, right? Mod z is less than 1. Now, here you can see there is no restriction to this term, right? If there is no restriction to this term, our restriction only to this term. So, here what we need to do is, our f of z is now will be, just understand, the first problem will be slightly difficult for understand, but if I do 2 or 3 problems, it will be very easy for you to follow. What I'm going to do is, we need to expand this because mod z is less than 1, right? So here we need to expand this in mod z is less than 1. So we need to have this pattern. So either you have to have 1 plus x or 1 minus x. But here you can see z minus 1. So if I take minus outside, so we will have 1 minus z here and this will remain as it is. Now I can write this term to be minus 1 minus z whole power minus 1 minus, and this will be z minus 2 whole inverse. Now again, what term I need to take outside? Either it has to be in the form 1 minus x or 1 plus x, right? But here you can see, if I take 2 outside, we will have, or I'll take minus 2 outside. So if I take minus 2 outside, minus 2 outside, we will have, this will be plus and this will be z minus 2 whole inverse, right? Yeah. So we will have, okay, let me do like this. It will be easy for you to understand. So let me take 2 outside here. Take minus 2 outside here, so we'll have 1 minus z by 2, right? Yeah, so this will be minus 1 minus z whole power minus 1, this will be plus 1 by 2, 1 minus z by 2 whole inverse, right? 1 minus z by 2 whole inverse. So now we can apply the formula, right? So minus of 1 minus z whole inverse, so this is nothing but 1 plus z square plus z cube and so on, plus 1 by 2 and 1 minus x whole power minus 1. So this is 1 plus z by 2 plus z by 2 whole square and so on. Right? Yes. Or you can also simplify this to summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus of z power n. You can rearrange this whole term into like this. Plus 1 by 2 z by 2 whole power n, right? So also you can also write this term like this. That's it. So we'll move on to the second. We need to expand now in 1 is less than mod z is less than 2, right? 1 is less than mod z is less than 2. So 1 is less than mod z is less than 2. So what you have to do is, what is our f of z? Our f of z is 1 by z minus 1 minus 1 by z plus 2. Now, you can see, you can split this into two parts, right? So split this into two parts. So, for this term, we will have 1 is less than mod z. And for this term, we will have mod z is less than 2. So, 1 is less than mod z means, our mod z, 1 is less than mod z means, what I can write is, mod 1 by 1 is less than mod z. So I can write that term to be, if I bring z to this side, so I will have 1 by z is less than 1, right? 1 by z is less than 1. And here, mod z by 2 is less than 1, right? Mod z by 2 is less than 1. So here, you need to expand 1 by z is less than 1. Here z by 2 is less than 1. That means you have 1 plus x whole power minus 1 formula. And you have 1 minus x whole power minus 1 formula. So here x has to be 1 by z, right? And here x has to be z by 2. That's it, right? So very important. So there are only 4 types, right? There are only 4 types. The first type is this. Second type is this. Third type is this. And the next type is, I'll do the next problem, right? So we have only these 4 possibilities. So less than 1, greater than 1, or in between 1, right? Yeah. So I think it will be easy for you to understand now. So you split this into 2 parts. Now split this into 2 parts. Yeah. So here we should expand like 1 plus 1 by z or 1 minus 1 by z. In place of x, you should have 1 by z. Here in place of x, here you should have 2 by z by 2. So what I can do is, I should have 1 minus 1 by 1 plus or minus, right? So 1 plus or minus x whole power minus 1. So here it can be 1 plus or minus 1 by z. It has to be in this format, right? If it has to be in this format, what should I take common outside? First, you will have, I need to take z common here, right? If we take z common, we will have 1 minus 1 by z. That's it, right? Here, we should have 1 plus or minus z by 2. So, 1 plus or minus z by 2. So, I should take 2 common here. So, we will have z by 2 minus 1, right? So, this will be 1 by z, and this will be 1 minus 1 by z whole power minus 1. Here if I take minus outside, so it will be plus 1 by 2, and this will be 1 minus z by 2 whole inverse. That's it. Now we can expand this, right? So you should always remember this. So here you should expand in the, you should have here in this format 1 minus 1 by z or 1 plus 1 by z. Here you should have 1 minus z by 2. Here we have z by 2 minus 1, so I'm just taking minus outside. And then I'm making this as 1 minus z by 2. Now you can expand this, right? So 1 minus 1 by z is 1 plus x square plus x cube and so on plus 1 by 2 into 1 minus z by 2, right? 1 minus z by 2 is 1 plus z by 2 plus z by 2 whole square and so on. That's it, right? This is the Lorentz series expansion for in this region. Now we'll move on to the third region. So in third region, we will have mod z. Mod z is greater than 2, right? You should always have something less than 1. So that means I can write this to be mod z by 2 is greater than 1, right? That means you should always be less than 1. So I can write 2 by mod z is less than 1, right? So, we should have a series expansion either in the form 1 plus or minus 2 by z whole power minus 1, right? Yeah. So, what is our f of z? We are only restricting to our 1 by z minus 1 minus 1 by z minus 2. Here, there is no restriction to this term. Here, we are restricting, we should make this series. Here, we should always have 1 minus z whole power minus 1 or 1 plus z whole power minus 1, right? Because you can see the first problem here. In first problem, mod z is less than 1. Here we don't worry about this second term, right? So we should always expand this as 1 minus x whole power minus 1 or 1 plus x whole power minus 1, right? But here what we are doing is, here there is no restriction to first term, but the restriction to second term. So here you should always expand this in, if I take minus outside, this will be 1 minus z. And here you should have in this format 2 by z. So if I want to have 2 by z, you should have to take 2 z common here. So z minus 2 by z, right? So this will be minus 1 minus z whole power minus 1 minus 1 by z into 1 minus 2 by z whole power minus 1, right? That's it. Now you can proceed with the problem. So, we'll move on to the third region. Mod z is greater than 2, right? So, what is our first f of z? our f of z is 1 by z minus 1 minus 1 by z minus 2, right? Yeah. So mod z is greater than 2. That means in this region, mod z by 2 is greater than 1, or 2 by mod z is less than 1, right? So here you need to have 2 by z common, right? Here you need to have a series of the form 2 by z. But what about here? Mod z is greater than 2. That means it should also be greater than 1. That means mod z by 1 is greater than 1, or 1 by mod z is less than 1, right? So here you should have a series of the form 1 plus or minus 1 by z. Here you should have a series of the form 1 plus or minus 2 by z, right? That is what we are doing here also. So whenever in the first series, what we are doing is mod z is less than 1. So mod z is less than 1 means, so it is already in the format, like correct format. So we will have 1 plus z or 1 plus or minus z. If mod z is less than 1, what about here we are, it is also less than 2, right? That means mod z by 2 is less than 1. So we should have in this expansion, you should have a series of the form 1 plus or minus z by 2. So you can see that's why only we are having 1 plus or minus z by 2 here, right? So if something is less than 1, right, you should have, for the part here there is no, there is, it is not mentioned here. So for this is also less than, if mod z is less than 1, it will be less than 2 also, right? Yeah. So for this condition, you make an arrangement to this, and for this condition you make arrangement to this, right? So there are only 4, right? The first is mod z is less than 1, second is in between, and third is mod z is greater than 2. So again, if mod z is greater than 2, it should also be greater than 1 also. So here you should have a series of the form 1 by z, here you should have 2 by z. So if you want to make 1 by z, you have to make z common here, right? 1 minus 1 by z. Here you have to make 2 by z. That means 2 by z means I need a 2 common here. So 1 minus 2 by z, right? 1 minus 2 by z. Now we can expand this, right? So 1 by z into 1 minus 1 by z whole power minus 1 minus 1 by z into 1 minus 2 by z whole power minus 1. Then you can continue, right? Okay, continue here. So first problem will be difficult for you, and slightly difficult for you to understand. But if you do a lot of problems, it will be very, very easy. And so on. Minus 1 by z. That's it. This is the Lorentz series expansion for in this region, right? In this region. So we will solve one more problem here, right? One other problem. The same sort of problem. One condition, less than 1. Greater less than 1, greater than this, and in between this, right? So we'll solve one more problem. If you understand this problem, then these two problems will be very easy for you, right? Yeah. So now we'll move on to the problem. Now first you can see that similar sort of problem. First is less than 2, greater than 3, and in between 2 and 3, right? Yeah. So first we need to resolve this into partial fraction, right? Now you can see partial fraction can only be done if the degree of the numerator is strictly less than degree of denominator. But here you can see both the degrees are equal. Here it is 2, here it is equal to 2. So what you have to do is, this is very elementary, you are not in school. So f of z has to be written as 1 plus a by z plus 2 plus b by z plus 3, right? So that means our z square minus 1 divided by z plus 2, z plus 3 has to be written in the form 1 plus a by z plus 2 plus b by z plus 3. So we will multiply by same method as you do here, multiply by z plus 2, z plus 3 on both sides. So we will have z square minus 1 is equal to z plus 2, z plus 3 plus a into z plus 3 plus b into z plus 2. I am multiplying this on both the terms, right? Both sides. on numerator. So we need to find the value of a and b. So father, what I'm doing is put a is equal to, sorry, put z is equal to minus 2, right? If z is equal to minus 2, you will have 2 minus 2 square is 4. So 4 minus 1 is equal to 0 plus a into minus 2 plus 3 b into 0. That means 3 is equal to a, right? A is equal to 3. Now what I'm going to do is put z is equal to minus 3. So z is equal to minus 3. So you have to be very careful that I am adding 1 because both the degrees are equal. So if z is equal to 3, we will have minus 3 square is 9. So 9 minus 1 is equal to 0 plus a will be 0, b will be minus 3 plus 2. So that means our b is equal to minus 8, right? So therefore, our f of z is, so whenever you have a Lorentz series, first you need to factorize our f of z, right? You need to make a partial fraction. So our f of z is nothing but 1 plus 3 by z minus 2 minus 8 by z plus 3, right? Yeah, so this is our f of z. Now we'll get back to the problem. So first, understand very carefully, that is, reason very carefully, it's very, very important, right? Yeah. The first reason is mod z is less than 2, right? The previous problem, here we have mod z is less than 1, right? If mod z is less than 1, mod z is also less than 2, right? Yeah. So again, I'm using the same technique here. If mod z is less than 2, this implies mod z is also less than 3, right? Yeah. So we have to get something less than 1. So that means our mod z by 2 is less than 1. Here our mod z by 3 is less than 1. Is less than 1. So here you should make a series in the form z by 1 plus or minus z by 2. Here you should make a series of the form z by 3, right? Yeah. So this means mod z by 2 is less than 1. Here z by 3 is less than 1. So we need to expand. So our f should have this z plus 2. Here you should have z by 2 here. Here you should have z by 3 here. So our f of z will be 1 plus 3 by, here you should have z by 2. So z by 2, you have to take 2 outside. So take 2 outside, you will have z by 2 plus 1. And here you should have z by 3. That means you have to take 3 outside. Z by 3 plus 1, right? Yeah. So I can write this as 1 plus 3 by 2, 1 plus z by 2 whole inverse minus 8 by 3, 1 plus z by 3 whole inverse. So that means 1 plus 3 by 2. So when expand this, we will have 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on minus 8 by 3 into 1 plus z by 3 whole inverse, right? Again 1 minus z by 3, 1 minus z by 3 plus z by 3 whole square and so on. So you can also write this as 1 plus 3 by 2 into summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 whole power n z by 2 whole power n plus summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus 8 by 3, right? Minus 8 by 3 into minus 1 whole power n into z by 3 whole power n. That's it, right? It's a very easy problems. Second one, second solution is we need to expand this in between mod 2 less than mod z is less than 3, right? So we need to expand this in this region. So when you expand in this region, what you will have? So you split this into two parts. Split this into two parts. So that means 2 is less than mod z and mod z is less than 3. So this means 2 by mod z is less than 1. You should always have less than 1. So here mod z by 3 is less than 1. That means in the first term, you should have 2 by z. Here you should have z by 3, right? So what's our f of z? Our f of z is 1 plus 3 by z plus 2 plus or minus 8 by z plus 3, right? Yeah. So you can see in this first term you should have 2 by z. In second term you should have z by 3. So this will be 1 plus 3 by, you should have 2 by z. So if you have 2 by z means you have to take z outside. So 1 plus 2 by z plus minus, here you should have z by 3. So z by 3 means you should take 3 outside, right? Yeah. So z by 3 plus 1. So this is nothing but 1 plus 3 by z I can take outside. This is 1 plus 2 by z whole inverse minus 8 by 3 1 plus z by 3 whole inverse. So this I can write this as 1 plus 3 by z. So we expand this, you will have 1 minus x plus x square and so on. And here you will have minus 8 by 3 1 minus x plus x square and so on. So this I can write this as 1 plus 3 by z into summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 whole power n into 2 by z whole power n minus 8 by 3 summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 whole power n 2z by 3 whole power n. That's it, right? This minus 1 whole power n. It's a very easy, right? Yeah. So now we'll move on to the third subdivision. Third subdivision is we need to expand this in mod z is greater than 3, right? Mod z is greater than 3. So we'll go on to that problem. Mod z is greater than 3. So what is our f of z? Our f of z is 1 plus 3 by z plus 2 minus 8 by z plus 3. So mod, here you can see there is a restriction to this term. So if mod z is greater than 3, it should also greater than 2, right? So mod z is greater than 2, mod z is greater than 3. These are the two restrictions to these terms, right? Yeah. So here these are the two restrictions. Here these are the two restrictions. So I think it will be easy for you to follow now. So that means mod z by 2 is greater than 1. That means 2 by mod z is less than 1. Here mod z by 3 is greater than 1. So z by 3 by mod z is less than 1. So here you should have in the form 2 by z. Here you should expand in the form 3 by z, right? So 2 by z, here you should expand in the form 3 by z. So you should have here, so let me change the color. So 1 plus, here you should have 2 by z. So if you have 2 by z, you have to take z outside, right? Yeah. So 1 plus 2 by z. Here you should have 3 by z. So 3 by z means you have to take again z outside. So depending upon this region, you have to make this substitution adjustment here, right? Now you can follow 1 plus 3 by z, 1 plus 2 by z, the whole power minus 1, minus 8 by z, 1 plus 3 by z whole power minus 1. Now you can follow the next step, right? So this is, you just expand this as summation minus summation n is, you can write this series to be summation minus 1 whole power n 2 by z whole power n. Here you can write this to be summation minus 1 whole power n 3 by z whole power n. So the answer will be minus 8 by z plus 3 by z plus 1. This is the required series, right? So that's it. So these are the three important, so this problem can be anything, but these are the only three they will give, right? So only thing you need to do is, suppose if you have a problem like 2 is less than mod z minus 1 is less than 2, is less than 3. So this is the fourth case, right? The first case is less than 2, second case is in between 2 and 3, third case is greater than 3, and the fourth case is, suppose in place of z, you will have some other terms like z minus 1, z minus 2, right? That is the fourth case. So I think that's also very easy. So time permits, I can do one problem at that also. Okay, let me give you one problem. I'll make third problem is our f of z is equal to 1 by z plus 1 z plus 3, right? So expand in Lorentz series. The first region is mod z is less than 1, second region is 1 is less than mod z is less than 3, the third is mod z is greater than 3, and the fourth is 0 is less than mod z plus 1 is less than 2. So I think you can do these three sums in your own, right? So if mod z is less than 1, it is also less than 3. So for the case 1, mod z is less than 1, mod z is less than 3. So here you should have z by 3 is less than 1. Here you can have z as it is, right? So you make these two substitution in these first, you need to expand this in partial fraction. I forgot to say. So if you expand this in partial fraction, you will have 1 by z plus 1 into z plus 3 is equal to a by z plus 1 plus b by z plus 3. Now you find the value of a and b. So the answer will be 1 by 2 into 1. A will be 1 by 2, b will be minus 1 by 2. Right? Yeah. So or else you can also take 1 by 2 outside. So if I take 1 by 2 outside, the series will be 1 by z plus 1 minus 1 by z plus 3. So here you don't make any substitution because already it is z. Now here you should have z by 3. That means you have to take 3 outside here and then expand. First case will be over. For second case, 1 is less than mod z for the first restriction. And here you have to make mod z is less than 3. That means 1 by mod z is less than 1. Here mod z by 3 is less than 1. So in the first case, you should make 1 by z. So that means you have to make z common here in this term. And here you have to make 3 common. Then you can expand. And for this, mod z is greater than 3. That means mod z by 3 is greater than 1. And 3 by mod z is less than 1. If mod z is greater than 3, it is also greater than 1 also. So that means mod 1 by z is less than 1. So here you have to make 1 by z. Here you have to make 3 by z. Right? Yeah. So you can do these three problems in your own if you have understand the previous two problems. Now I will do the fourth problem and then I'll finish off the video. Right? Yeah. The fourth subdivision is 0 is less than mod z plus 1 is less than 2. That means you need to expand in z plus 1. You need to expand in z plus 1. Yes. So here what we do is 0 is less than mod z plus 1. Put u is equal to z plus 1. So this will become 0 is less than mod u is less than 2. So what is our f of z? Our f of z is given to be 1. You take this f of z, right? 1 by z plus 1 z plus 3. So 1 by z plus 1 z plus 3. Now you have to convert this in terms of u. So I can write z plus 1 to be u, and I can write z plus 3 as z plus 1 plus 2. So again I can write this as u into u plus 2, because this is u, right? So our f of u is 1 by u into u plus 2. Now we need to expand this in 0 is less than mod u is less than 2, right? So that means 0 is less than mod u and mod u is less than 2. So if you have 0 like this, you don't need to expand this term. You can keep this as constant as it is. So you don't need to expand this. Here we will have u by 2 is less than 1. So here in this you have to make u by 2, and 1 by u you don't need to do anything. So if I do that, we will have 1 by u. Now you need to make u by 2. That means you have to take 2 common. So if 2 common, 1 plus u by 2. So this will be equal to 1 by 2u 1 plus u by 2 whole power minus 1. So this will be equal to 1 by 2u, and this will be 1 minus u by 2 plus u by 2 whole square, just a series expansion, right? And this will be 1 by 2u into summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 whole power n u by 2 whole power n, right? Now you can replace u to be z plus 1. So replace u to be equal to z plus 1, then you will have the required answer, 1 by 2 into z plus 1 plus something. So therefore this is the required series. So whenever you have here something, you just make a substitution and then you make f of z in terms of u, and then you make a normal problem as it is, right? So that's it. So we have a, so if you want, so okay, I'll do one more problem and then I'll stop this topic, right? So fourth problem is, so let me do a last problem. Expand 1 by z square minus 3z plus 2 in Lorentz series in the region 1 is less than mod z is less than 2, right? Yeah. So what is the first, we'll factorize this. So z square minus 3z plus 2. So you just take a factorization, you just make a factorization here. So we will have z minus 2, z minus 1. Now we apply partial fraction a by z minus 2 plus b by z minus 1. Now you find the value of a and b. So we'll get a, these are very elementary, right? We'll get a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 1. So our f of z is nothing but 1 by z minus 1 minus 1 by z minus 2. So we need to expand in this region. 1 is less than mod z less than 2. So we split this into two parts and mod z is less than 2. So this means 1 by mod z is less than 1 and this is mod z by 2 is less than 1. So here you should have 1 by z, here you should have z by 2. So if you want to have if you want to have 1 by z here, you should take 1 by z. So I should take z common here. So this will be 1 minus 1 by z. And here you should have z by 2. So z by 2, that will be 2 common here, right? If you take 2 common, you will have z by 2 minus 1. So this I can write this as 1 by z. 1 minus 1 by z whole power minus 1. Here you have to interchange, right? This will be plus 1 by 2 and this will be 1 minus z by 2 the whole power minus 1. That's it, right? So 1 by z, you just expand this and this will be 1 by 2 into, you just expand this, you will get the required answer, right? Yeah. So let me give you one problem for exercise. If you have any doubt in exercise, let me comment in the comment box. So our f of z is z by z minus 1 into 2 by z expand in Lorentz series in the region mod z is less than 1, and second is 1 is less than mod z is less than 2. The third is 0 is less than mod z minus 2 is less than 1. Right? Yeah. See, third is mod z is greater than 2. And the fourth is this case. Right? Yeah. So first you will have to make partial fraction. Right? If you do the partial fraction, you will have f of z to be equal to 1 by z minus 1 plus 2 by 2 minus z. This is a partial fraction for this. So expand in the first, you will have mod z is less than 1. If it is less than 1 and mod z is less than 1, mod z is also less than 2, because you have 2 and 3 are constant. Now you will do the same problem as you did, right? Yeah. Or else you can also take minus outside here. So you can have z minus 2. You can also have 1 by z minus 1 minus 2 by z minus 2. So that means here you should take mod z by 2 is less than 1. Here you should take z by 2 comma. That means you have to take 2 common here. Here you can keep as it is, right? You just have to take minus outside here. Now for the second, 1 is less than mod z is less than 2. This is the same follow same technique. And for fourth, let u is equal to z minus 2, right? U is equal to z minus 2. So then what will be our f of z? Our f of z is z my z minus 1. If I take minus outside here, you will have z minus 2, right? Yeah. So I can write this as z is equal to u plus 2, right? U plus 2, and this is minus u, and I can write z minus 2 as u, and I can z minus 1 as z minus 2 plus, I have to make minus 1. So minus 2 plus something, you have to get minus 1. Right? 1. So that means this will be u plus 2 minus u into u plus 1. Right? Now you can expand, right? You can expand this in the region 0 is less than mod u is less than 1. So you don't worry about this minus u. So here you should take mod u is less than 1. So what you do is you just have the answer will be, so u plus 2 by 2, and this is nothing but 1 plus u whole power minus 1. So we expand this, and then you substitute u is equal to z minus 2 in the answer, right? Yeah. So that's it. So Lorentz series over now. So if you want, I can also solve the previous question papers on Lorentz series, right? That's it. Listen to the next video. Goodbye. Thank you.